Yes, good evening, class. A very good evening to all of you. This is your favorite Grade Up Gate YouTube channel, and I, Rakesh Talreja, welcome you to the fresh evening, fresh topic of root locus in the startup series for electronics and electrical. Now, you are watching the startup series on the Grade Up Gate YouTube channel for electronics and electrical, and the subject that we are dealing since the past week, okay, since the past week, that is the control systems. That is the control systems. And till yesterday, we have done about the Rauth-Hurwitz analysis. Last week, we were talking about the time response analysis. Past two classes, we have taken about the Rauth-Hurwitz analysis, the important Rauth-Hurwitz analysis. Yes, good evening, all. Good evening. Let me just see how many of my dear students are there. Yes, Ajesh, Raviteja, Satvik, good evening. Harsha, Harinathan, very good evening. Zion, Sriram, Manish, Shruti, Arun. I hope you all are fine at home, safe at home, enjoying your lockdown studies. Okay, so root locus is what, as I told, I'm going to start today. Root locus is what I'm going to start today. And I have, for your convenience, I've broken the root locus into three parts, root locus YouTube class into three parts, so that you get more and more number of cases. And what I'm going to deal with, yes, Manikanta, good evening. In this root locus classes, this is just a brief introduction about me. Many of you already know that I am Rakesh Talreja and I have secured All India rank 9th in the GATE examination. I have completed my master's from Indian Institute of Science located at Bangalore, and my major area of expertise are engineering mathematics and quant. I'm a fun lover of mathematics, so I take it for all branches. Apart from that, EMT, control, digital and signals. Control is what we are going through right now. Here, I've been taking these subjects for more than 10 years now. Right. So, what I'm going to do with the root locus, dear students, just I will give you the hint. Okay, let me start and then I give you the hint how I'm going to break my lectures. Yeah, Harsha, you can refer to, I think, Kreisig. Yes, dear students, and before we start the class, it's just the introduction. Before we start the class, why don't you share the link of this video? You know, yesterday we were solving such important and very, very wonderful cases of the Rauth-Hurwitz, and today is again very important topic, root locus. So please quickly share the link to your friends in all your groups, spread it across. And apart from that, all who are live, at least you can like the session. Let's start with a good energy, show some positivity so that we start with the positive frame mind. Grade Up has so much to offer to you on the YouTube, on your channel, Grade Up Gate YouTube channel. And apart from that, there are several free classes running on the app as well. That is the ESC mains classes. I'm also taking the ESC mains control systems, as you know. ESC mains control system classes I am taking daily at 9 a.m. from Monday to Friday, and there are some CFT classes by Ashutosh Saxena sir and Vijay Bansal sir. The tomorrow's topic for the mains classes is Nyquist and Bode. I have taken dedicatedly Nyquist only today. Tomorrow Nyquist and Bode, because in the mains examination Bode is very less important. In the GATE it is important, but in the ESC mains it is less important, but Nyquist is very, very important. So I am focusing Nyquist more. Okay. Raviteja, while solving, what type of problem, which topics, if you can specify the topic, that would be fine. Okay. Chaliye. So also I'm having the concept on fingertip classes on electromagnetic theory. That's 2 p.m. every day. I am fine, Ramu. How are you? Yes. Did you not attend the class yesterday? I thought you were missing yesterday. Okay, so concept on fingertips. Tomorrow's topic for the concept on fingertip class is the polarization class number 2. Today I have discussed the concept of polarization, and tomorrow I'm going to show the variety of the polarization questions. Right. Now, let me begin up with the homework, and then I'm going to move towards the root locus. I've given you a homework, my dear students. Anyone having the answer for that? Anyone having the answer for this homework question? Okay, let's start with the homework question and then continue further our analysis to the root locus. So let's solve it together. The loop transfer function of a negative feedback system, GSHS, is given as. Okay, Ramu, you're working. Okay. Yeah, so Raviteja, whatever doubts you had earlier in steady state and Rauth-Hurwitz, I think I have taken sufficient depth. So you may be able to solve it. You may be able to solve it by whatever I've told. Okay. And if you have any further doubts, you can tag me on the Grade Up app. Yes, Satish, Harsha, Satuvik, Prakhar, Sri Ram. Yes, so this was the homework that I've specified. GSHS equal to KS plus 11 upon SS plus 2 S plus 8. What is the value of K for which the system is marginally stable? Gate 2020, current year 2 marks question. And I have even taken a question where they ask what is the value of K for marginally stable and then what is? Because when the system is marginally stable, it is oscillatory. So what is the frequency of oscillation? They also ask about that. But yahan pe they're not even asking the frequency of oscillation. The very simple, only they are asking the value of K. Yes, let's proceed now. So what is the characteristic equation for the Rauth-Hurwitz? I definitely need the characteristic equation. That is 1 plus K S plus 11 is divided by S plus 2 S plus 8. Okay, so forming the characteristic equation, it is going to be S. 2 plus 8 is 10 S square, 2 into 8 16 S plus K S plus 11 K equals 0, or S cube plus 10 S square plus K into plus 16 plus K multiplied by S plus 11 K equal to 0. Okay. Right, S cube plus 10 S square plus 16 plus K S plus 11 K equal to 0. Fine. Now, feeding this into the Rauth array immediately, S cube, S square, the first beginning row, what will be the coefficient for S cube? It is 1 and 16 plus K, and for S square, it is 10 and 11 K. So 1, 16 plus K. Very simple question, I think, for 2 marks in the current gate paper. And then 10 and 11 K, right? Don't you feel so? As compared to whatever variety of questions we have been doing for Rauth-Hurwitz in the past two classes, stands out to be easy. So practice always for the all variety of cases, easy to complicated. So you are able to solve all gate questions. So this is 160 plus 10k minus 11k. So automatically, directly, calculations are also much simple. No complex, no complicated calculation. It is directly 160 minus k by 10. This is 0. Going to the S raised to the power 0 row. Going to the S raised to the power 0 row. Okay, this will be x into 11k by x, so that is 11k, last element is 0. Okay, yes. So, you want the system to be, I've told you clearly in the yesterday's class, you want the system to be marginally stable. And just wait on, dear students, we are with this problem only, we are going to, those who are new to the session, don't worry, it's a root locus session only, but I'm just taking with the Rauth example to move towards that. Actually, I've given this homework, but with this, I'll move forward. So don't worry. Just keep on your patience. Those who are new to the session for the root locus. So marginally stable system means you have J omega roots. Okay. And when is the possibility of the J omega roots? The possibility of J omega roots come when you have the auxiliary equation. And auxiliary equation is definitely associated with row of zeros, everything we have discussed yesterday. And row of zeros matlab it is only occurring in the odd power, it is only occurring in the odd power, right? So odd power means take this S power 1 row, and this element, second element, is already 0. What you will do is take 160 minus K equal to 0, and K is equal to 160. K is equal to 160. That's the answer. That's it. Okay, if they ask frequency of oscillation, you can form, the auxiliary equation 10s square plus 11k equal to 0, find the frequency of oscillation. That is also work. That is also possible. Okay, so my dear students, now if k is equal to 160, I am concluding that the system is marginally stable, right? The system is marginally stable. Okay, but if K is less than 160 or if K is greater than 160, then what will happen if we see? If K is less than 160, look into this, everyone. Just look into this. I'll hide my view. If K is less than 160, and when you subtract from 160, obviously the answer is positive. So all the coefficients, are plus, 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 right? Plus, 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 plus. Because K is, anyways, I've told that the K is taken as positive only by default. So plus, 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 plus. All coefficients of the same sign and no RHP roots, and the system will be stable. Okay. System will be stable. Okay. So I'll specify, actually greater than 0 it has to be. Okay. Yeah. If K is greater than 160, then If k is greater than 160, so when you subtract, this is going to become negative. Okay, this is going to become negative. And then you have sign changes in the first column. And because you have sign changes in the first column, the system is going to be unstable. Okay. Okay. And such systems are basically what? Such systems, dear students, are basically known as conditionally stable systems, which are stable for some values of k and which are not stable for other values of k. Okay, which are stable for some values k and which are not stable for some values of k. Such are conditionally stable systems. And as you know, that condition comes up with the loop gain k, with the constant loop gain k, right? So that clearly shows that if I vary the gain of the system, the stability is affected. And not only stability, okay, other parameters like zeta, okay, that is known as a damping ratio and all that will be affected. Yes, Natarajan, good evening. Now, if I look into the characteristic equation, first of all, it is a third order characteristic equation. Had it been a second order characteristic equation, I can find you anything like find a frequency of oscillation, find a damping ratio. Here you can say the frequency of oscillation. The method of calculating frequency of oscillation I've told yesterday. But what about the damping ratio? Can you find out by formula the damping ratio? No, it's not the formula that we have discussed. Formulas we have discussed up to the second order control system. And it does not mean that you can't find the damping of a third order control system or a fourth order control system. You can find it, but analytically it is difficult. But you can find it with some graphical techniques. Yes, Vijay Pratap, very good evening. You can find it with some graphical techniques. Okay. So with this calculation, what you are able to see that we are Rauther-Waitz, we are focusing on the roots of the characteristic equation, and the roots of the characteristic equation are varying with respect to k. Okay. So now what I'm going to do, moving from this analytical method, determining the range of k for stability. Okay. And not only stability, suppose if I'm interested in other parameters like calculating the gain margin. Gain margin, we study in the relative stability. Okay. Gain margin of the system, damping ratio or damping factor of the system. Analytically, it is not possible. Okay. So Rauther-Waitz can only say about stability. But we are now going to introduce the method because we know that roots of characteristic equation vary with respect to k. Roots of the characteristic equation vary with respect to k. So we are just going to have the plot. We are going to have the plot of the roots of the characteristic equation with respect to k. And such plots are nothing but I am moving towards the root locus. Such plots are nothing but the root locus. And not only with respect to stability, root locus may, you will be able to comment about stability. You will be able to comment about marginally stable case, that is frequency of oscillation. You will be able to figure out the value of zeta, the damping. You will be able to figure out gain margins and other stability parameters. Right. So it is helpful in many aspects of what all it can be applied, that we will learn case by case. Okay. So that's what we are now entering into the root locus. That was just the yesterday's homework question. And I've clearly shown you that yes, roots of characteristic equation vary with respect to k. So now we are going to do the graphical analysis of that roots of the characteristic equation. And dear students, for you on the YouTube for root locus, I am going to take three classes. Okay, I'm going to take three classes this week. That is Thursday is today, then Friday and Saturday. And how I'm going to deal with it, I'll just give you a hint about it. Okay. That is class number one today. Basic root locus plot. Starting with the simple thing, that is going to explain you all the properties. Okay. Okay. Yes, my camera has stuck. I'll just check it once. Just give me a minute's time. My camera has to. I'll just take it in a minute's time. Yes, it's fine, I think. It's fine, I think. Maybe due to some technical glitch, it might have stuck. Yes, so that's fine now. Yes. No, it's not buffering now. I was just trying to reinitiate my setup. Now the camera is here. Yes. Maybe the camera had stuck. Yes, come back. So first class, today I'm going to take you about the basic root locus plus to make you understand all the properties and all the basic concepts of root locus. Okay. Going to the second class. I'm going to take the important root locus cases with respect to very, very, very important, mark this thing, that is the angle of departure and arrival. So mostly whatever cases that I take tomorrow, that is my tomorrow's YouTube class, we are going to have the angle of departure and angle of arrival concept, right? And then the third case, I'm going to talk about most important MCQ or NAT questions. Most important MCQ or the NAT questions, right? Most important NAT or the MCQ questions that can be expected in a paper like GATE or engineering services examination. So this is how we are going to break. Okay. This is how we are going to break. Right. Okay. So today let's take some basic root locus plots, and that basic root locus plots, within that plots, I'm going to tell you the steps. Okay. Dear students on this YouTube, no need. What timing, Swan Kumari? It is daily 8 p.m. The YouTube class is daily 8 p.m. as it is having right now. It is daily 8 p.m. So this is today, basic root locus plus. This is what I'm starting today, then tomorrow, and day after tomorrow. Okay, so day after tomorrow, I'm going to cover all very, very important. And that very, very important question is going to open. That is my guarantee, that is going to open up all the concepts of root locus. And there's one very important concept and very important question that repeatedly comes up from the root locus, and that is the calculation of angle of departure and arrival. Okay, so don't let it start with the basic root locus plots. And with the basic root locus plots, I'm going to give you the properties. Okay, and the steps with the question itself. Let's go by the question approach. Okay, because I have been allotted three classes for root locus. Okay, I have been allotted three classes for root locus. And if I start derivation, I know whatever the steps are there, automatically with the question I will tell. So root locus, not like the Rao-Hurwitz root locus, I'm following the question technique, concept through question technique. And within the question, you're going to understand each and every technique. And it is more beneficial for you to learn about the question. Otherwise, just one complete session, I'll be talking about the derivation. Okay, if you want to learn more about derivation, you can come and join me on the grade up courses. There we have sufficient time, but here also it's not about time, it's all about your questions, and I'm going to make it comfortable for you. Okay, so with that energy, I'm starting. So yes, as I've already defined, root locus with the plots of the roots of the characteristic equation. So it is the locus of the roots of the characteristic equation when the gain parameter k is varied from 0 to infinity. When the gain parameter k is varied from 0 to infinity. Okay. Yes, Shravan, that's what I'm telling. MCQ, NAT, all variety questions I'll be taking in the third class. Okay, tomorrow, angle of departure and angle of arrival, that I have to explain you. That is very, very important. And today, some basic root locus plots. I've given you the division of the root locus. Okay. So, root locus is, whenever I say root locus, generally k is varied from 0 to infinity. Okay. And if k is varied, okay. Just a second, dear students. This is minus infinity. This is minus infinity, less than k, less than 0. That means k is negative. Then we have the complementary root locus. Okay. Such a technique is known as complementary root locus. Few questions and few steps changes with the complementary root locus. Root loci is the case when you sketch the root locus for all values of k. That is from minus infinity to plus infinity. Minus infinity to plus infinity. And root contours is the case when some other parameter. What can be that other parameter? I'll take a question to explain you. Okay. Apart from the loop gain k, there can be some other parameter that is varied. And such plots are root contours. Okay. Yes. Yes, Ishu Moni, it's going to be available in the YouTube later anyways. But follow live. That's more important. You can interact and you can learn in a very good manner while you are attending a live class. Okay. So I'll just start with a very, very, very important and simplest question of the root locus. But that is important. It has been asked in almost every type of competitive exam. Okay, only data can be changed. Suppose S plus 1, S plus 2, yeah, S plus 1, S plus 5. But this question is very important with respect to all examinations, that is, whether it is GATE or, you know, ISRO exam or engineering services, mains, pre, both. It has been asked in the mains exam also. Such question has been asked in GATE. Okay, with GATE you have options, but you know, we'll go to the options question later on. I've told in that dedicated question class, I will take the options and NAT question. Okay, but let us first learn. Then objective obviously means tricks. Okay, but you can't go to the tricks if your concepts are unclear. The first is concept always, and then second is the trick. So we'll take it both. We'll take both. Okay. So GSHS is given to you as K upon S, S plus 1, S plus 3. So just follow some simple procedures with me. Follow the simple procedure with me. Sabse pehle, I start by taking this function. GSHS equal to K divided by S, S plus 1, S plus 3. Okay. Now you know that GSHS is known as what? GSHS is, we have been calling this from the several classes. This is open loop transfer function. Okay, so what are the open loop poles? That also I have defined. Now, what are open loop poles? Poles of the open loop transfer function. So, what are the open loop poles here? That is 0, minus 1, minus 3. Okay, what are the open loop zeros? What are the open loop zeros? Okay, open loop zeros. Open loop zeros are nil. There are no zeros available for this function. Open loop zeros matlab the zeros of open loop transfer function. So dear students, how many open loop poles? It is 3. And how many open loop zeros? It is equal to 0. So I call P as the number of open loop poles and I call Z as the number of open loop zeros. Just keep on following with full concentration. Okay. Yeah. And then let's hold on for the doubts for some time. Let me explain you the whole procedure. So I have the set of open loop poles and open loop zeros. Okay. Yes, good evening, Vaibhavi. So, in any root locus, how many branches are there? Number of branches. See, basically, the idea of the number of branches is equal to the order of the characteristic equation. See, sir, why? Why? What I am telling you, what is root locus? I have defined that root locus, if I go to the previous case, root locus is the plots of the roots of characteristic equation. How many roots of characteristic equation you have? For every root, you have one branch. Okay, so suppose if you make the characteristic equation here, 1 plus GSHS equal to 0, that characteristic equation is going to be cubic. Like the last question also we have solved. That marginally stable question. So that root locus. Good evening, Vishal. So that characteristic equation is third order. Third order characteristic equation matlab three roots, and for every root you have one branch coming up. So basically number of branches of root locus is equal to order of characteristic equation. And remember this as simply by the formula, the order of characteristic equation can be written as maximum of poles or zeros. Which of them is the maximum? Okay, so maximum of the number of open loop poles or the number of open loop zeros. So there are three poles and no zeros. So for this question, it is going to be 3. It's just a formality step, but because it's the first question, I'm telling you, you should know how many branches. How many branches? Order of the characteristic equation. How many roots you have, that many branches will come in the root locus. Fine. Then next. Where does the root locus branches starts from? The root locus branches starts from the open loop poles. Okay. That is, what are the open loop poles here? 0, minus 1, minus 3 that I have written. 0, minus 1, minus 3. Okay. Then, where do they end? Root locus branches ends on open loop zeros, or if open loop zeros are not available, or at infinity. So here, is there any open loop zero available? Just keep watching with concentration. There is no open loop zero available here. Nil. So all the three branches will end towards infinity, infinity, infinity. Okay. I am going to next take a problem where we have equal number of poles and zeros. Okay. So there will not be any branch going to the infinity. Okay. No. If you have any zeros, n will be equal to max of p comma z. It is not that the pole and zero will cancel. I'm not talking issue, Moni. It's not the case that pole and zero is at the same location. It can be different location. Now, suppose you may add a term here, k s plus 2. Still, the order will be 3. S plus 2 is not cancelled anywhere. Final equation will be cubic only. Okay, I think maybe you're talking about the case of pole zero cancellation. Chaliye. So, root locus branches ends here. root locus branches will end here. Now, for all the branches going towards infinity, for all the branches going towards, traveling towards infinity, okay, root locus is approximated by asymptotes. Okay, now asymptote is a very important thing, especially in the MCQ or NET question. It is going to be one of your biggest tool in cross verifying the options. Some questions only by the knowledge of asymptotes you will cross check. Yes, sir, this is the option A. No need to solve the question completely. Answer solved. So I'll present that questions to you also. Okay. Root locus is approximated by Na issue moni n is not. What you are talking about p minus z is something different. Ravi Teja, p minus z nahi. It is max of p comma z. What is p minus z? I am going to talk about now. That is not the number of branches. You have learned wrong. Jahan se bhi aapne padha, that is wrong. P minus z is not the number of branches. ठीक है रवि तेजा एंड इशू मोनी करेक्ट योरसेल्फ जहां से भी आपने देखा दैट इज रॉन्ग दैट इज नॉट द नंबर ऑफ ब्रांचेस सो हाउ मेनी असिम्प्टोट्स यू रिक्वायर फॉर द ब्रांचेस दैट आर गोइंग टुवर्ड्स इन्फिनिटी नाउ सी हियर हाउ मेनी ब्रांचेस गोइंग टू इन्फिनिटी ठीक है थ्री वाई थ्री बिकॉज थ्री ब्रांचेस हैव स्टार्टेड एंड आई डोंट हैव एनी ओपन लूप होल आई एम गोइंग टू कॉल दिस एज लेट मी राइट डाउन द नंबर ऑफ असिम्प्टोट्स ठीक है, these are important asymptotic calculations. I'll just write down once again. Number of asymptotes. Okay. Number of asymptotes. N. It is given by P minus Z. The difference between the number of poles and number of zeros. ठीक है, how many zeros are less? How many zeros are less? That many branches will travel towards infinity. Okay. So n here is equal to 3 minus 0. That is 3. Okay. Yes. Now, angle of asymptotes. Now, 3 asymptotes. Angle of asymptotes. I'm writing every formula first with this question so that next question will be comfortably taken by us. Angle of asymptotes. With the real axis. Angle of asymptotes with the real axis, and that is taken by the formula 2k plus 1 divided by n into 180 degree, where k is equal to 0, 1, 2, etc. up to n minus 1. Okay, up to n minus 1. So here there are 3 asymptotes. So for this question, theta will be 2k plus 1 divide by 3 into 180 degree, where k is equal to 0, 1 up to n minus 1, and n minus 1 is equal to 2. Okay, n minus 1 equal to 2. So substitute the 3 values of k, you are going to get the value of 60 degree, 180 degree, 300 degree. 60, 180, 300. Dear students, if you have not solved any problem root locus till now, then also it is going to be very much clear. So just keep following. Just keep following and just keep liking the session, those who have not liked till now. Okay. 60, 180, 300. These are the three angles that is going to come up. Okay. Then next calculation, next point is centroid. Centroid. That is intersection. Intersection of the asymptotes with on real axis. Intersection of the asymptotes on the real axis, and that is given by the formula x centroid summation of poles minus summation of zeros divided by P minus Z is divided by P minus Z. Okay. Yeah, Satish, you can also write the 300 degree as minus 60. That is also fine. 300 or minus 60 is one and the same thing. One is anti-clockwise, another one is clockwise. So that is also correct, Satish. Fine. The summation poles minus summation zeros divided by P minus Z. This is the formula to be applied for centroid. So what is the summation of poles? Poles matlab location of poles. So 0, minus 1, minus 3. What are the zeros? Nil. ठीक है, तो देर इज नो जीरो, सो दिस इज नॉट टू बी टेकन अपॉन पी माइनस जेड एंड दिस वन इज माइनस 4/3 और माइनस 1.33. ओके, माइनस 1.33. तो दिस इज अबाउट द सेंट्रॉइड. ओके, देन द नेक्स्ट कैलकुलेशन. Then the next calculation. Yes, I hope everyone is following. I am solving it detail. The first question, solving it complete detail. Breakaway points. Breakaway points. Yes. Breakaway points. For the breakaway points, write down. Now, from where? From the characteristic equation, write down K as a function of s, ठीक है, and solve dk by ds equal to 0, ठीक है, and then check for valid breakaway points. And I'll tell you few things now before I start calculating. You know, what happens at a breakaway point in the graph, you are going to see that at a breakaway point, two or more root locus branches will intersect. Correct. And there are three cases of breakaway. I'm going to explain you all three in my root locus classes. Okay, first is breakaway. Commonly we call it as breakaway, but it can be actually breakaway. It can be break in. What is breakaway and break in? Difference between them, I'll explain with the diagram. And it may be the case of complex breakaway. So there are three cases of breakaway points. One is the breakaway, one is the break-in, and one is the complex breakaway. And I'm going to explain you all three. Okay, I'm going to explain you all three case by case. And whatever question I'm going to take is going to make the steps as well as concepts gradually clear. With every question, we'll try to learn a concept. Okay, so breakaway, break-in, or complex breakaway. Three cases I will show you with the graph. Not showing right now with the question, appropriate question. This question will have breakaway. I will take another question that will have break-in also, and another question that has complex breakaway point. All three are possible. Okay, fine. So now for this question, let us right now go for this question. Okay. Coming back to this question. Yes, Zion, complex breakaway is possible, and I'm going to show you with an example. It is definitely possible. Okay. Yes, Rujana, it is possible sometimes that there is no breakaway point. Yeah, breakaway point, if it is there at the starting point only. Matlab, whatever are the poles. Okay. That also may happen. That also may happen, Rujana. So for this question, first let us write down the characteristic equation. That is 1 plus k divided by s plus 1. S plus 3. ठीक है, yes, Zion and others, I'll tell you clearly, yes, complex breakaway points are actually there. ठीक है, how does complex breakaway point look and what happens? Let's wait for that question and I'll explain you. So solving this, you get S cube plus 3 plus 1, 4 S square plus 3S plus K equal to 0. That means what is K? It is minus of S cube plus 4S square plus 3S. I told you, na, write down K as a function of S. Write down K as a function of S, and then what? And then solve dk by ds equal to 0 and check for valid, because not every solution will be valid. What is valid? That also will be clear very soon. So first of all, dk divided by ds equal to 0. That is minus of 3s square plus 8s plus 3 equal to 0. 3s square plus 8s plus 3 equal to 0. Correct? Yes. Minus of 3s square plus 8s plus 3 equal to 0. Fine. Now, solve this equation. Solving this equation, what is the value that you are going to get? You are going to get the value. Just a simple quadratic formula. Na? So, it is minus b plus minus root over b square. That is 64. Minus 4ac becomes 36 divided by 2a. Right, exactly, Satvik. So approximately after solving, you should be getting the value of minus 0.45 and minus 2.21. Take it everyone directly. Minus 0.45 and minus 2.21. That is what is the value going to come. Minus 0.45 and minus 2.21. Okay, that is the value of S. Now, which of them are valid? Okay, which of them are valid? I'll explain you with the graph. Which of the two is valid? I'll explain you with the graph. Both are not the breakaway points. Only one of them will be the breakaway point. Which of them is the breakaway point? I'll explain you. Okay. Only one last calculation I need to do here. Only one last calculation. That is to completely sketch the graph. What is the intersection of the root locus with the imaginary axis. For approximate sketching, it is not required. But I will complete for this question. I'll complete for the sake of this question. Okay. So right now, without this step, let us do. Yes. Right now, let us do it without this step, and then I'm going to use this step also for make it more clear. Okay. Yes, Harsha, these roots are actually, you know, once we go into derivation, there I explain this. These roots are actually minima and maximum value of k, okay, such that k remains real. Okay, k remains real. Breakaway points represents maximum or minimum values of k. Okay. Chaliye. So, intersection of root locus with imaginary axis, why it is required, I'll tell you. But without that also, approximate sketching, I'll be able to do the approximate sketching without that. Clear to everyone up to this point? Okay. Okay. So, I'm just leaving some space. I will come back and do that. Because for this, what is only thing that you have to do is the Rauth-Hurwitz. Is to use the RH criterion. Okay. So, I'll use that. Which quadratic equation? Yeah, Geeta Shri, it is going to be 2 into 3. Yes, Geeta Shri, it's going to be divided by 2a, obviously. Divide by 2a. So, I will come back to this step, but without this step also, I am telling you approximately you can sketch. Okay, so that you will also know the quick sketching and the detailed sketching. Both you should know. Okay, both you should know. So, there is one property that I will mention. And then I'll show you how the graph is. Existence of root locus on real axis. I will speak about this property. Then your graph will be totally clear. And with that, I'm starting the graph also. Okay. And then I'll explain the property simultaneously. Just wait for that. Okay. So I'm sketching the graph and as well as I'll explain you the property both. Yes, guys, so we are starting with the graph now. We are starting with the root locus graph. Okay. So, taking the complex S plane. So, yes, I'm just starting my sketching. Just wait for it. It's not going in the correct direction. Yes. This is the real axis and consider this as your imaginary axis and follow the calculations with me. Okay. Okay. Yes, Tevindra, thank you for that. And I have very, very, very much upgraded my content as compared to that time what you might have read. Upgraded the whole times. Maybe very soon I'll try to take some mathematics. It's really interesting. Maybe I'll try to take it up on YouTube or GradeUp app somewhere. Okay, so let us start now. Sabse pehle, dear students, what you're going to do now, the main thing I'm going to tell you, the technique for sketching. Sabse pehle, sketch the poles and zeros of the GSHS. So what are the poles and zeros of the GSHS that we know? That is 0, minus 1, minus 3. Because the branches will start from poles na and end on zeros. Here there is no zero, but there are the poles. So let us plot these poles. Let me just highlight the poles here. So one of the pole is at origin. that is 0. Another pole is at minus 1. This is minus 1. Let me take this as minus 2 and suppose this is minus 3. Okay. 0, minus 1, minus 3. These are the poles. There are no open loop zeros. Okay. Now, before sketching the branches, first sketch the asymptotes. First take the asymptotes. That is going to make the world simple for you. Okay, so first sketch the asymptotes. And what is the centroid? Asymptotes ke liye you need three things. How many asymptotes? What is the angle? What is the angle of asymptotes? And what is the centroid of the root locus? Centroid matlab intersection of the asymptotes on the real axis. Okay, so I have done all the three calculations. So centroid is minus 4 by 3. That is minus 1.33. Angle is 60, 180, 300. And there are three asymptotes. That is what we all know now. Right. So taking this point, guys, taking this point, say this is minus 1.33. From this, take an asymptote first, approximately, just have a freehand sketching. Just have a freehand sketching, not necessary to take a geometry box and take up so much of time. Freehand sketching. Centroid, matlab all the asymptotes will start from centroid. What is the first angle? Approximately take a line at the 60 degree angle. That means this angle, my dear, this angle should be 60 degree. Okay. Fine. Approximately. Next angle is 180. 180 matlab the angle is measured with respect to what? Always the angle is measured with respect to the positive x-axis, positive real axis. The 180, positive x-axis to negative x-axis. So where is the 180 degree angle? That is towards the negative x-axis. That is towards the negative x-axis. Clear? Towards the negative x-axis. I'll say that these green lines are basically asymptotes. You should be clear ki what I'm sketching right now. First, I'm sketching the asymptotes. Okay. And there's a third asymptote. There is the third asymptote that is at 300 degree. 300 matlab 60 less than 360. That is 60 degree downwards basically. That is my third asymptote. Okay. And asymptotes, I've told you earlier, asymptotes have been taken for what? For all the branches which are going towards infinity, they are approximated by asymptotes. So whatever my branches are there, they will be seen tangential to the asymptote near infinity. They will be seen tangential to the asymptote near infinity. Fine. So these are the three asymptotes. Now after sketching the asymptotes, I am sketching my branches and I will use the red color for sketching the branches. So yeah, students, how many branches we have concluded? We have concluded with three branches. Okay, we have concluded with three branches. Right, we have concluded with three branches. Okay, now the branches starts from open loop poles. So there's an open loop pole at 0. There is the open loop pole at minus 1. Okay, branches start from open loop poles. So where will the branches start from with respect to minus 3? For that only, I'm going to explain you this property of the root locus. Existence of the root locus on real axis. Where does the root locus exist on the real axis? So root locus branch will exist on a section of the real axis, on a section of the real axis where total number of poles and zeros to the right, where the total number of poles and zeros towards the right of that section, okay, towards the right of that section is what? Is an odd number. Okay, and not only for the sketching of this complete detailed problem, but even when I'm going to take the MCQ class, this property will also be helpful in eliminating the option. So remember, root locus will exist on a section of real axis where the total number of poles and zeros to the right of that section is an odd number. Correct? So, look at this. No. Look at this section first of all. Understand this property with me within the root locus. Everyone understand. If I talk about this section, that is this section from minus infinity to minus 3. Will the root locus exist here? See, so from this section, look towards the right. Mane kya bola? Total number of poles and zeros towards the right. So how many poles and zeros you are able to see towards the right? 1, 2, total three poles, right? Total three poles and no zeros. So that is total number of poles and zeros is three. That is an odd number. And because it is an odd number, yes, the root locus will exist on this section. Okay. But if you look from, yes, dear students, if you look from this section, if you look from here, that is minus three say minus one ki baat karte hain. Okay. If you look from here, how many poles and zeros are seen towards right? That is two. That is two. Okay, and that is E1. So root locus will not exist on this section. That means, now listen, before I go forward, that means I have to start a branch. I have to start a branch from the pole minus 3. Okay, every branch will start from an open loop pole. Na? So there is a branch that I will start from minus 3. That branch should be started where? Left or right? Maine existence bata diya. The root locus will exist up to minus 3. But between minus 3 and minus 1, it is not existing. Because the total number of poles and zeros seen towards the right is an even number. So obviously, the branch from minus 3, the branch from minus 3 is going to travel backwards. Okay. And dear students, I'll just add on important points here. The root locus branch starts and the starting value of k, root locus, okay, root locus is the locus of the roots of characteristic equation when k is varied from 0 to infinity. So starting value of k is 0 and towards infinity, I will mention here that k tends to infinity. I'll just hide my view. Yeah, I'll just hide my view here. K equal to 0, matlab starting branch, and k tending to infinity, matlab when the branch ends. Okay, where the branch starts and where the branch ends, the value of k at the starting is 0, the value of k at the ending is infinity. Okay, so this is one branch of the root locus completed. This is one branch of the root locus completed and now I am taking the next one. Now I am taking the next one. Yes. Okay. Yeah, so I will bring that view once again. It's hidden right now, don't worry. Now, the second branch, here the root locus does not exist. So let me remove that. We have checked that root locus does not exist here. Here it has existed and I have shown you. Now next case, dear students, up to the minus 1 we know it does not exist. But tell me between minus 1 to origin, will the root locus exist on the real axis? The property is what? The property is existence of the root locus on the real axis. I am talking about the real axis. Okay. So between minus 1 to 0, will it exist? Will it exist? Okay. Will it exist? To see, if I see from this section towards right, if I see from this section towards right, how many poles and zeros you are viewing? How many poles and zeros you are able to say? It is one. Okay, that is an odd number. That is an odd number. And for odd number, the root locus will exist on the real axis. So yes, between minus one to origin, root locus will exist. That means what, dear students? The branch that will start from minus one will be towards right. But the branch that will start from 0, that will be towards left. Because if I look into this section, ye bhi tally kar lete, let's tally this also. If I look at this section and see towards the right, how many poles and zeros? Nothing. Now in the right, there is nothing, no pole and zeros. So that is nil, that is 0. That will be obviously counted in the even because odd matlab 1, 3, 5 I need. So will the root locus exist here? No, 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 no. That means when you start the root locus from the origin, it should start towards left. Not to the right because of the odd criteria property, odd number property. Is that fine to everyone now? Yes. So that is what I am starting the branch from origin towards the left and I am starting the branch from the pole minus one that is towards the right. Okay. Let me erase this now. This is the odd number criteria. Acha, with this you have seen that the branch, with this automatically you are able to see that there is a branch that started from minus 3 and it has gone to infinity. But when it's going to infinity, if you are able to see, it is also going in the direction of asymptote. That green line is still visible. One of the asymptote, 180 degree. One of the asymptote, it is at 180 degree. So always the branch will end at infinity because there is no open loop zero. And infinity matlab in the direction of asymptote, in the direction of asymptote. Now the other two branches. Yes, come back. Now come back. Very important concept. Two branches have started. Okay, one is from minus one, other from origin. And what is the initial picture you are getting? You are getting the picture that both the branches are traveling towards each other. Na? Both the branches are traveling towards each other. And when the branches travel towards each other, what will they do? What will they do? They will come and collide. When the branches are traveling towards each other, they will come and collide. They will come and intersect. And that intersection point, students, That intersection point is the breakaway point. I told now where two or more root locus branches intersect, that is the breakaway case. There can be three cases. I am talking about breakaway. Next, we'll talk about break-in and complex breakaway also. Okay, and we have solved the breakaway point by dk by ds equal to 0. And what are solving this? What is the value of s that I've obtained? Minus 0.45 minus 2.21. Right. But which of them is valid? Which of them is valid? No, it is two branches. Na? Every branch starts from one pole issue. So two branches traveling. One is from minus 1 and one is from 0. They are traveling in the opposite direction and they will intersect. They will intersect. They will meet. They will meet at the breakaway point. Okay, so now I'm going to give a conclusion here. See, just look into this slide now. I had calculated two breakaway point. Minus 0.45, minus 2.21. This is not the breakaway point, but minus 0.45 is the valid breakaway point. In short, we call it as BAP, valid breakaway point. And why that is valid? It should be clear to you because the intersection is happening between minus 1 and origin. There is no intersection that is to be occurred at minus 2.21. Minus 2.21 will be approximately here. But there is no intersection that is seamed, that is looking at minus 2.21. Okay. So, maine kya bola tha? I've got two breakaway point, but one of them is valid, that is minus 0.45. Okay. So, how do you calculate breakaway point? Dk by ds equal to 0. Which of them is valid? That we come into the graph and decide ki where there is a possibility of intersection, right? Okay, so what I'm going to do now, dear students, now I'm just about to complete this plot. I'll just take this value. This is approximately minus 0.45, the breakaway point. So travel both the branches till the breakaway. Okay, breakaway is the case where they intersect. So they are traveling in the opposite direction and they intersect. And after intersection, remember three simple strategy for root locus. Three simple strategy. Number one, start the root locus. Start from where? Open loopholes. Okay. After starting the branches, make them intersect. How do you know whether there is an intersection or not? That will be told by the breakaway point. Start the branch, make them intersect. And after the intersection, jab ye mel milap ho chuka hai, uske baad kya karenge? Finish. Okay. So after the intersection has been done, make them go towards their termination. And where do the branches terminate? Either at zeros, but this question does not have open loop zero. So they will go where? They will go towards the asymptote. They will go towards the direction of asymptote. Okay. So I repeat, start, intersect, end. Keep these three simple terms in mind to have a quick sketch of the root locus. Start, intersect, and end. Starting where? Open loop poles. Intersection where? Breakaway points. Termination where? Either zeros or infinity. But here there are no zeros. So take them towards infinity. And infinity in which direction? Towards the direction of asymptote. So now, that is why I have sketched asymptote earlier. With the knowledge of this asymptote, I am going to take my branch. I am going to now take my branch approximately just traveling close to or parallel to the asymptote near infinity. That is what is the shape of the root locus, and this question is concluded. This is finished. Right. I will add on few more points, but it is actually finished. This root locus is completed. And I'll again mention, I've told you now, the root locus branches starts from poles, matlab k equal to 0. Starting value of k is 0. They terminate towards asymptote, and towards the termination, the value of k that exists towards termination is k tending to infinity, and here also k tending to infinity. Okay, k tending to infinity. Yeah, you should just wait on problems. We have more variety of problems. We have divided the lectures into three classes. So many cases are going to come up. So just wait for that. And this, my dear students, I'll highlight this separately. This is nothing but your breakaway point. Breakaway. Now, I've told you there are three cases of breakaway. Okay. Breakaway, break-in, and complex breakaway. I've told you now there are three cases of breakaway. Breakaway, break-in, and complex breakaway. So, breakaway means Breakaway means, listen, when two branches are traveling on the real axis and they intersect, two branches traveling in opposite direction on the real axis and they intersect and they break away towards the complex plane, that is a breakaway point. That is the breakaway point, right? Here the breakaway point is minus 0.45. Okay, what is break-in then? I'm going to show you the break-in also with a question. What is break-in? When two branches travel from the complex plane and they intersect. Two branches, if they travel from the complex plane and they intersect on the real axis and then move on the real axis. Matlab reverse of this, opposite of this. Two branches come from the complex plane, intersect on real and move on the real axis. That is break-in. I am going to show you break-in also. Okay. And complex breakaway means that I'm going to show you in one question. Complex breakaway also will be shown when two branches travel in the complex plane. They intersect in the complex point only and they move in the complex plane only. There is not going to be the involvement of the real axis. So just wait everything. Once you see, then you will understand. Okay, so this is the breakaway point. S is equal to minus 0.45. And as I've told you, if I come back to this step, without this, the question is completed. You know, without this also, the question has been completed. Okay, but if you want to calculate, because if you are able to see that, yes, at this point, the root locus intersects. At this point, the root locus intersects. What? Intersects the imaginary axis. Intersects the imaginary axis. So, what is that value? Where does it intersect? What is that value? Okay, what is that value? Okay. That can be exactly found by Routh Hurwitz, but already you have seen that without even this step, I have solved my question. But for your clarity, what you have to do is characteristic equation S cube. We have already taken the characteristic equation S cube plus 4S square plus 3S plus K equal to 0. Now, this can be done by you. Solve using RH criterion. Everyone knows RH criterion. We have learned about the RH criterion last two class. You are going to get K equal to 12. Okay. Just a second. I think there is something hanging here. Maybe I'll take it here. K equal to 12. And by the auxiliary equation, by the Routh Hurwitz, by the auxiliary equation, solve the auxiliary equation. You are going to get the point that S is equal to plus minus J root 3. Plus minus J root 3. Okay, this can be solved by you. So I'm just writing here. S is equal to, this will be J root 3. Value of K will be 12. And this will be minus J root 3. Again with K equal to 12. And this is the complete root locus. This is the complete root locus. Okay. Complete root locus. Okay. Yeah, Manish. Break-in will come into picture when you have zeros. When you want to conclude towards zeros. Yes. That case will come. We are going to go towards that. Yes, Manish. That is correct. Okay. That is correct. Okay. Yes. Alright, dear students. So this is the complete root locus. Routh Hurwitz also you can solve. Okay, Routh Hurwitz also you can solve, but without that, because you know, ultimately, if you have to go to the MCQ questions also, so not necessary to apply Routh Hurwitz. Asymptotes are enough to tell you where the branches are going to go. Start, intersect, and conclude. Okay. And even I'll tell you, even if it is a MCQ question, now listen, then I'll tell you one thing. You also need not find the breakaway point. Need not find, because MCQ questions will have four options and you have to identify the shape. So it is very much clear that branch from minus one is starting towards right. Why it is starting towards right? Because this property must be very clear to you. Okay, where does the root locus exist on the real axis? This is very important. Okay, so you should be able to judge that yes, the branch from minus one will start to the right. The branch from origin will start to the left because they are traveling in the opposite direction. So they will intersect, and when they intersect, it is a breakaway point. Need not calculate the exact value. Yeah, there is some breakaway point and then to move towards the asymptote. Okay. Move towards the asymptote. Right. Yes. So So with this, if you want to have a clear look at this once again, so that we take another problem. Yes. Have a clear look at that so that we have another problem. Yes. Okay. Simply issue. There's a very simple logic behind that. Okay. Because what your characteristic equation is, this issue I'm just talking to you. The characteristic equation is what? 1 plus k into some zeros divided by poles term equal to 0. So what do you write n upon d equal to? N upon d. It is minus 1 by k. So if k is 0 beta, if k is 0, you get n upon d as infinity. Okay, 1 upon 0 is infinity. And if n upon d is infinity, that means d should be 0. And d equal to 0, denominator 0 matlab open loop poles. Okay, so corresponding to the open loop poles, that is the starting of the root locus, k is 0. And similarly, if you take k equal to infinity, n upon d is 1 upon infinity, that is 0. And if n by d is 0, it is possible if n is 0, numerator is 0. And when you equate the numerator of a function to 0, you get the open loop zeros. Okay, that is why the branches, when they terminates on the open loop zeros, it is k tending to infinity. Or if open loop zero is not available, then obviously infinity. Okay, that's the very simple logic behind that. Okay, so always at the poles, at the starting points, k is 0. And at the ending points, k is infinity. Now, dear students, taking another question. Okay, taking another question now. Just follow. Let us do it together. Right. If any confusion till now, please comment on. Okay, I'm reading your comments. Yeah, Sriram, which root locus travels to upper and lower asymptotes? For that we'll have to do some more calculations. Okay, we'll have to take up some calculator and see how the roots are actually varying. But that is irrelevant. See, because root locus, remember this point also. Looking into this, I'll tell you one point, that root locus, one more important point I will add up. Root locus will always be symmetric. Root locus will always be symmetric with respect to the real axis. The root locus will always be symmetric with respect to the real axis. Please remember that, with respect to the real axis. Okay. So that is pretty much clear. So because it is symmetric. Issue. Just be clear ki what is the open loop transfer function. You know, sometimes many students are confused between open loop and closed loop. So make it clear. Yes. So because it is symmetric, what is only mattering to you, Sriram, is that whether the branches are traveling towards infinity or traveling towards RHP or not. Because if the branches travel towards RHP, then the system becomes unstable. Okay. So that is required for stability, unstability. But you know, if there are branches going in the complex plane, both will go towards the RHP because of the symmetry. So it does not matter ki which is going towards up or which is going towards down. Okay. For that, we'll have to do some more detailed calculation. It is possible to determine, but not required. Okay. For our root locus steps. Okay. Now, dear students, next question. Okay. Yeah. I'll first take up a question so that to understand break in point. Looking into the time, I would first like to take up a question so as to make you understand the break in point. So as to take up the break-in point. So let's take up the question of the break-in case. Yes. So come to this question. And with this question, we are also going to talk about some important transient parameters, nature of the response, when it is underdamped, overdamped, critically damped, and negatively damped. Okay. Negatively damped, obviously we know that the system is unstable. A unity feedback control system has GS equal to KS plus 2 upon SS plus 1. Sketch the root locus of the system. Okay. Yes, Manish, that's what we have been considering. We have been considering open loop poles only, poles of the open loop transfer function. Okay. So, dear students, starting this question once again together with you. What is GS, HS? It is only GS because HS is unity. Bola na, unity feedback. Unity feedback matlab open loop transfer function is just equal to GS. Otherwise, you take GS, HS. So, it is KS plus 2. Divided by S plus 1. Okay. Now understand it's going to again make you some concepts more clear. So first of all, I write down the open loop poles. First of all, I want to write down the open loop poles. ठीक है. And student, as I've told, there are two more root locus classes. So please follow the schedule and better subscribe the Grade Up Gate YouTube channel. You automatically get the notification of the classes. Hit the bell icon so that you get the notification of the classes. And अभी तक भी if you have not liked, please do not miss to hit the like button. ठीक है. Let's all stand motivated enough and study. Open loop poles, dear students, what it is? 0 and minus 1. 0 and minus 1. Okay, so how many of them? Quantity is 2. Open loop zeros, S is equal to minus 2. S is equal to minus 2. So how many open loop 0? It is 1. How many open loop 0? It is 1. Okay, so how many asymptotes will be there actually? How many asymptotes? Let me quickly complete with the asymptotic calculation. Asymptotic calculation. Why I require asymptote? Because only it is very irrelevant. Asymptote will not be very much required here. I'll tell you with this question, I'll tell you one shortcut also. So stay tuned. With this question, I'll tell you a simple shortcut also. Without any calculation, how to sketch the step, how to sketch the graph. That shortcut also I will tell you very soon. Okay. So we know that the number of branches is given by max of P, Z. So how many branches will come up here? 2. Okay. Okay, then the branches starts at the open loop poles, so that is 0 and minus 1. Branches ends where? They ends on the open loop zeros, so there is one zero at minus 1 and another one will go towards infinity, and for this branch going towards infinity I need the asymptote, right? Why do I need the asymptote in the root locus? The asymptote is required for the branches going towards infinity and one branch going towards infinity. Why only one branch? Because one zero is available, na? 1, 0 is available. That is why I told you, let me write down the asymptote results. Not much required here. N is equal to 1, P minus Z, that is 1. Okay. Centroid will be summation of poles, so that is 0 minus 1 minus the zeros. The zeros is at minus 2 divided by P minus Z, so that is just 1. ठीक है, that is just 1, and the angle of asymptote theta, it will be just only one angle and that will come up as 180 degree. Okay, now the main steps. ठीक है, main steps, and I am going to tell you the shortcut without any calculation. Without a single calculation we are going to sketch the plot. That also I'll consider. That is very helpful for the MCQ question. Now let me calculate the breakaway. Breakaway points. Okay, so let's solve this completely and then wait for the simplest method to come up. Breakaway points. So what is the characteristic equation? 1 plus k s plus 2 divide by s plus 1 equals 0. So what is the value of k? It is, write down k as a function of s, that is what I've told you. The k will be minus of s square plus s divided by s plus 2, s into s plus 1 multiplied. So minus of s square plus s upon s plus 2. Okay. Now you have to solve what? Now you have to solve the equation dk by ds equal to 0. So once I differentiate this, what we are getting? Let us differentiate it. Let us do it quickly. So s plus 2 whole square. Denominator square. Numerator by denominator form. And then first s plus 2 constant, differentiate the numerator, that is 2s plus 1 minus s square plus s constant, differentiation of denominator is equal to 1, and that is equal to 0. Put dk by ds equal to 0. Okay, simplify the numerator, so you get 2s square plus s plus 2 to 4s plus 2 minus s square minus s equal to 0. Only numerator equal to 0 is enough. Okay, so 2s square minus s square, so that is s square, okay, plus 4s plus 2 equal to 0. Okay, yes, Rujana, correct. Approximately, this is what you are going to get. So you can solve this equation, dear students, and you are going to get it as minus 0.6 and minus 3.4. Minus 0.6 and minus 3.4 is what you should be getting. Approximately, minus 0.6 and minus 3.4. Okay, so which of them is valid or not? Minus 0.6, minus 3.4, which of them is valid or not? For that, we will just wait into the graphs, and within the root locus graph, I will tell you. Okay. Yes, within the graphs, I will tell you. Now, dear students, quickly going for the sketches. Quickly going for the sketch of this, right? Quickly going for the sketch of this. That's it. And I don't need more calculations. Okay? I don't need more calculations. So I'm just quickly moving towards. I'm just quickly moving towards the sketch of this. Right. So let me start with. Let me start with the sketch of this root locus. Yes. Okay, so let us start with the sketch of this root locus. Real axis, imaginary axis. What is the first thing I told you to do? What is the first thing that I've told you to do? Is to sketch the poles and zeros. Is to sketch the open loop poles and open loop zeros. So how many open loop poles and zeros are available? I'll show you to the basics. How many poles? 0 and minus 1. Okay. And how many zeros? It is at minus 2. Okay. So 0 and minus 1. Okay. 0. Origin. And then take a considerable distance. This is minus 1. Minus 1 is also the pole. Okay. And then almost equivalent distance, approximately freehand sketching, this is your 0. 0 is at minus 2, there's a pole at minus 1 and there's a pole at origin. This is the pole 0. Okay. This is the pole 0. No Manish. Both will come up here. Both will come up here. Now, dear students, follow. Yes, issue. Okay, now, first of all, what you need to do, not very relevant for this question, but still because we have calculated, I'll show you ki what is the use of asymptote. Hai na? Concept clear hota rehna chahiye, but not very hard and fast for this question. Asymptote. Now, if you remember, the centroid was calculated as one, only one asymptote, and that one asymptote was 180 degree direction. That one asymptote was in the 180 degree direction. Okay, that just wants to say that one of the root locus branch is going to travel towards minus infinity. Okay, minus infinity. Okay, that is my asymptote. Now, what I need to do next is state the branches. Red one, that is the branches. Okay, so how the branches will start. Okay, yes, actually, Ramesh, it's a subject to love actually. It's actually so much of graphical, so much of mathematics, and I am always a mathematics lover since my childhood. So it's definitely a subject to be loved about if you are really, you know, understanding it. Okay, chaliye. So branches starts from where? Branches starts from the root locus. And don't only love, yeah, control system is to be loved, but why don't you love the Great Upgate YouTube channel? Show your love to the Great Upgate YouTube channel. Hit the like button immediately. Yes, everyone hit the like button immediately. And where will the branch exist on the real axis? Now listen, everyone. Listen, everyone, with concentration here. If I start from here, okay, on every section, let us see on the every section. If I see from this section towards the right, how many total poles and zeros? How many total poles and zeros? 3. Okay. That is odd number. That is odd number. So yes, root locus will exist here. Okay. If I see on this section, dear students, between minus 2 say minus 1. Between minus 2 say minus 1. Okay. No, Manish. It's not generally true. For one asymptote, it is true. Okay. Between minus 2 say minus 1. How many total poles and zeros towards the right? It is 2, even number. So here the root locus should not exist. Now, here the root locus should not exist. Between minus 1 to 0. Between minus 1 to 0. Okay. If I see towards the right, how many poles and zeros? Total 1. That is an odd number. So yes. The root locus will exist here. And if I see in this section now. Okay, that is towards the right of origin, in the right half plane. Will the root locus exist here? How many poles and zeros towards the right? 0. Counted as even number. So no. Root locus will not exist there. Right. So where does the root locus exist? That is left of minus 2 and between minus 1 and origin. These are the two real axis sections where the root locus can exist. Fine, everyone. Now branches starts from poles. branches will start from pole, the one branch from minus one, one branch from origin. So where will the branches start? That is why the real axis existence is necessary to check. So from the minus one, the branch will start towards right. Okay. From the origin, the branch will start towards left. Okay. So I will remove this. I've just shown you by the existence. I'm removing this. Okay. So once again, all my dear students, see what is the initial picture coming up as? There are two branches traveling in the opposite direction. So they must intersect. Intersect where? For the intersection only breakaway has come up. For the intersection only the breakaway is there. So what is the breakaway between 0 and minus 1? Yes, minus 0.6. This is a valid breakaway point. Okay, minus 0.6. So approximately here, let's approximately take it. Freehand sketching only. And other branch also travels towards this. They intersect. And after intersection, they go where? They go in the complex plane. Okay. Okay. Now, they go in the complex plane. And root locus, I've told you, it is always symmetric. It is always symmetric with respect to the x-axis. That is what I've told. Okay. Now, where will they go? They will try to go towards their concluding point. And what are the termination points? One of the branch will be terminated at this open loop zero. Another branch will be terminated towards infinity. Asymptote. Okay. So, obviously, because of symmetry, they can't just and come, one come here and one go here. Root locus is always symmetric. Okay. Root locus is always symmetric. Okay. So, what is the picture that is going to be created? Because of the symmetry, they are going to travel. I'll remove this. I'll write it later. They are going to travel in the complex plane. There is another breakaway point that is located at minus 3.4. Let's say this is minus 3.4. They travel to the other breakaway point. Let us say this is minus 3.4. Yeah, Ankita, yeah, the one is the centroid. Okay. And this one, because of symmetry, it travels in the lower half plane. And that is also going to come and collide here. They intersect here once again. This is one intersection point. Okay. And after intersection, what happens, students? After intersection, one of the branch is going to travel towards conclusion. The one conclusion is on the open loop zero. Another branch is going to travel towards the another conclusion. And for the another conclusion, you had the asymptote, the green one. That is towards the negative x-axis. Okay. So they are going to go towards the conclusion. I'll just mention this point is nothing but the breakaway point. What did I say about the breakaway point? When two branches are traveling from the real axis and they intersect and go to the complex plane, that is breakaway point. When two branches are traveling from the complex plane, intersect and travel on the real axis, that is known as what? That is known as, dear students, the break-in point. Generally, we call it as breakaway. In the calculation, we call it as breakaway only. But in the graph, we come to know whether that is the breakaway or the break-in. So, this point is nothing but the break-in point. This point is nothing but your break-in point. Right, everyone? Okay. No issue, it's true here as well. Yeah, why left direction you are telling Sharan Kumar? Because, see, where does the root locus ends? You will go in that direction only. Now, the root locus ends at open loop zero or towards asymptote. So, open loop zero is also in the left. Asymptote is also in the left. That is why they are going towards left. going towards left. Apart from that, if you want more detailed analysis, you can check using the route Hurwitz that, root locus is not going to go towards the right half plane. But not required, route Hurwitz is not required here. It's not required here. Clear everyone? So this is my break in points. I'll just mark the arrows. I'll just mark the arrows also of the root locus. This is my complex branch. The two complex branches come and intersect on the real axis, and that is where they intersect is the break-in point. I'll write down the value separately for the breakaway and break-in. Break-in is minus 3.4, and breakaway point is S equal to minus 0.6. Okay. Yes. Clear? Now, that is the complete root locus of this completed. Okay. Complete root locus of this completed now. Okay. I'll just mention the K equal to 0 and infinity points and move towards more calculation. The branches starts from open loop poles, and I've explained starting matlab k equal to 0. So at the open loop poles, it is k equal to 0. The branches concludes at open loop 0 or at infinity. And at the conclusion, you have to write k tending to infinity. Here also it is the conclusion. So k tending to infinity. Okay, k tending to infinity. Yes. So just have a view of this, and then I add on some more concepts. Yes, Satvik, 0.58 or 0.6 approximately, it's fine. Just have a view of this. Any other confusions, please let me know. Please let me know for any other confusion, dear students. Yes, all okay, so that I can take more concepts on this only. First of all, I'll take more concepts of this only. All okay, any confusion? Yes. Chaliye. So let us proceed forward in that case if it's all okay for you. Now, with this question, if you have seen, I'm going to take a little more concepts. I'll add on some slides. We are not ending the class as of now. So just wait on for some more time. Yes. I hope you are interested in some more concepts. So with this, okay. With this. Determine the range of K such that the system is underdamped, overdamped, critically damped, or negatively damped. Okay. Negatively damped. Okay. Nine Manish, branches are not from centroid. Asymptotes start from centroid. Right. Ankita, what specific point to be repeated if you say? Okay. Determine the range of K for the system to be underdamped, overdamped, critically damped, and negative damped. That is one important case now. That is one important case to be studied with this question. And as such a question comes, you don't have to solve by the second order formula. Question comes, given a root locus, what can question come in the MCQ? Given this root locus, identify what are the values of K, what is the range of K such that the system is underdamped, overdamped, critically damped or negatively damped. And for that, I will have to do one calculation. Okay. So just follow one calculation with me, everyone. What is the value of K at the breakaway or the break-in point? Okay. Value of K at the breakaway or the break-in point. Let me calculate that value. Okay. Now, breakaway or break-in point. I'll generally tell you how to find the value of K at any point. At any point which is lying on root locus. Because ultimately breakaway point or break-in point are both lying on the root locus only. Na? So any point lying on the root locus, lying on the root locus, lying on the root locus will satisfy what? Will satisfy, because root locus is a plot of the roots of the characteristic equation. So obviously any point now, if I pick up reverse, if I pick up any point on the root locus, it must satisfy the characteristic equation. That is 1 plus GSHS equal to 0. Okay. Or that means GSHS equal to minus 1. Rather than checking it as minus 1, what is the important condition that is broken? Number 1, mod of GSHS equal to 1. And number 2, angle GSHS, angle of the negative real number is actually taken as 180 or minus 180 degree. Okay. The mod of GSHS equal to 1. Angle GSHS equal to 180 degree. And to find the value of K, use the magnitude criteria. Mod of GSHS equal to 1. Right? Mod of GSHS equal to 1. Use this magnitude criteria. Mod of GSHS equal to 1 to find the value of K. Okay. So, I want you to calculate the value of K at the breakaway point. So what is the breakaway point? The first breakaway point is minus 0.6. Okay. Solve mod of GSHS. Mod of GSHS. So what is mod of GSHS? GSHS is KS plus 2. So 0.6 plus 2 divided by S into S plus 1 equals 1. Okay, just solve this quickly. Use your calculators quickly. I'll also use it parallelly so that we get the results quickly. Okay, KS plus 2 upon SS plus 1. Okay, that is what the function was. Okay, that is what the function was. So what I am getting? Yes. So I am getting the value of K as 0.17. Listen, I am getting the value of K as 0.17. Okay. Then at the other value, S, other breakaway value, that is the break-in value actually. The break-in value was minus 3.4. Use mod of GSHS once again, that is K, S plus 2 divided by S plus 1 equal to 1. Mod of GSHS equal to 1. From this, what is the value of K? What is the value of K that is achieved? Okay, so let me check that also. It is going to be 5.83 approximately. 5.83. And my dear students, one important point. This I'm solving this calculation to make you explain the concept of underdamped, overdamped, critically damped. But actually there have been several questions in GATE and ESE which only ask what is the value of K such that the point S is equal to something given, says that S is equal to something lies on the root locus, a repeated question. So what you will only do for solving such question? This criteria, mod of GSHS equal to 1. Mod of GSHS equal to 1. So this is just an individual expected question. Individual expected question. Mod GSHS equal to 1. So you will get many questions. You will get many questions, right? Yes. So K equal to 5.83, and I'll go and highlight these results in my root locus plot that I have taken. Okay. So At this point, I will mention one more thing. At the breakaway point, K is equal to 0.17. I'm just writing in the root locus everything. And what is the value of K here? What is the value of K here? That is obtained as 5.83. Break-in point pay, the value of K is 5.83. Clear, everyone? Yes, dear students, it's 47 likes. Can we hit the half century today for the root locus class? 3 more. Yes. How many are live? Yes, 3 more. Can we hit the half century immediately? Understanding important concepts. Yes. Let's quickly hit the half century today. Okay. So, determine the range of K for the system to be underdamped, overdamped, critically damped, and negatively damped. Okay, so we have already learned about the time response also, dear students. We have already learned about the time response, and what we are going to do, the first question says, write the range of case such that the system is underdamped. Just recall, what is the condition for the roots such that the system is underdamped? What is the condition for the roots such that the system is underdamped? Condition for roots such that the system is underdamped. Roots are complex conjugate, underdamped system matlab, underdamped system matlab, roots are complex conjugate. Roots are complex conjugate lying in, remember everyone, we have learned about the time response also in the last week in the LHP. So that you have to read from the root locus. So I'll just switch between the root locus and all. This is the root locus. For what value of k? For what value of k? Your branch is in the complex plane. Your branch is in the complex plane. So just look at this. Look at this. This one. Just see my pointer. This arc. This is in the complex plane, in the left half plane. Okay. And it starts with k equal to 0.17. That is why I calculated that first. K equal to 0.17. up to k equal to 5.83, from the breakaway to the break-in, from the breakaway to the break-in, but I want the answer of k. That is why I have calculated the k. That is why I have calculated the k. So let us write down the answer for the first part. The answer is, looking from the root locus, the range of k is 0.17 less than k, less than 5.83. clear now? Yes. Now second one. What was the second part of the question? Overdamped, then critically damped and negatively damped. Okay, so second is overdamped. What is the condition for overdamped? So that you have to recall from the time response that you have learned. For the overdamped system, the roots are real unequal lying in the left half plane. Okay. Yes, so I don't know, maybe it's competitor or what. Okay, maybe it's competitor or what, but that Rakesh Singh is back as Rohit Singh and now back as Nikhil. I know you are the same guy, don't try to act smart, Nikhil. Okay, Rakesh Singh, Rohit Singh, now the new name Nikhil Punita. What do you want to prove? Why do you are feeling jealous about our sessions? Just get lost from here. Okay. Yes, dear students, neglect such cases and concentrate here. Overdamped, the roots are real, unequal, lying in the left half plane. So where are the roots real and unequal? Follow my pointer once again. Yes. Real axis mein but unequal. So look at this arc, everyone. Just follow my pointer. Okay. This arc and the disc arc. Okay. From k equal to 0. This is also starting with k equal to 0. This is also starting with k equal to 0. Okay. So from k equal to 0 up to k equal to 0.5. Up to the breakaway point. Okay. The roots are real but unequal. At the breakaway they intersect and then they are equal. Okay. Then they are equal at the breakaway. Okay. So this is real and unequal, one region. This is real and unequal. Getting everyone? Okay, just for any confusion you can comment. Real and unequal. From where? K equal to 0, say k equal to 0.17. K equal to 0, say k equal to 0.17. Okay. Yes. So overdamped condition, 0 less than k, less than 0.17. Okay, less than 0.17. And one more will exist. I'll show you both. This is first. Okay. Now, just follow. Okay. At the breakaway point, okay, they have intersected, then gone to the complex plane, that is underdamped system. And at the break-in, they again intersect. Okay, and after intersection matlab they are equal, and then they move towards the real axis. Okay, real but unequal. One is in the right direction, one is in the left direction. Real and unequal. So what is this value of k at the break-in, everyone? 5.83. this is the value of k at the break-in, and till what? Till the conclusion, that is till infinity. Right. That is still infinity. So overdamped has two answers. Overdamped has two answers. I'll write down 0 less than k less than 0.17 or 5.83 less than k less than k less than infinity. Less than infinity. Okay. Right. Yes, so Grade Up team is back, I think, and the comments of Nikhil has been blocked. I know he's the same Rakesh Singh, Rohit Singh. I don't know why he's coming repeatedly to the Grade Up Get YouTube channel. Maybe some competitors are sending. Maybe because we are, you know, really learning and enjoying these sessions. So no problem. Back to back your, let's back your concentration here. So this is the answer for overdamped, right, everyone? Overdamped. Next case. Next case. Critically damped. And then we are almost done. Critically damped. What about critically damped case, students? Critically damped is the case when the roots are what? Roots are real and equal, lying in the LHP. Both the roots should be real and equal. And where do you see that on the root locus? This point exactly, where the branches intersect. Intersect matlab for the moment they have become equal. They are on the same location. And this point. Okay, so critically damped corresponds to what? Critically damped basically corresponds to the breakaway or the break-in point. Breakaway or the break-in point. Critically damped corresponds to the breakaway or the break-in point. Clear? The breakaway or the break-in point. Okay. Real and equal. So what is the breakaway and break-in point K value? I will write down the answer here. Yes. So the answer for K is 0.17 and 5.83. 0.17 and 5.83, both cases will be critically damped. Okay, one more thing was asked, but that does not exist here. Next question was, determine the range of K such that the system is negatively damped. And negatively damped matlab roots are in RHP. For negatively damped, the roots are in RHP. ठीक है, so ठीक है, no RHP branch is seen in this root locus. No RHP branch is seen in the root locus. No RHP branch is seen in the root locus. So no answer for fourth one. ठीक है, that means for no value of K, for no value of K, the system is negatively damped. Negatively damped obviously means the system is unstable. For no value of K, the system is unstable. That's what. And that is also an important analysis. That is also an important analysis. Actually, in MCQ, it will be a separate question. In MCQ, it will be a separate question that. In MCQ, it is a separate question that. Given a root locus, determine the value of K such that the system is underdamped or overdamped or critically damped or etc. Okay. Yes, Zion, undamped is not here again because we are not crossing the J omega axis, but underdamped. Okay. Even someone else also asked underdamped. So underdamped, I'm just repeating once. Okay, just look into this root locus. Underdamped. Undamped hai nahi yahan pe. There is no negatively damped and there is no undamped, Zion. Now look at this. Look at this. What is underdamped? I've written the condition first. Underdamped means what? When the roots are complex conjugate in the LHP, that is what we have learned in the time response. Roots are complex conjugate in the LHP, right? So when are the roots complex conjugate? At this point, till this point, the roots are equal. And then the breakaway, we have the breakaway point. And then see, this is where the roots are of the form x plus jy here. Roots are in the complex conjugate plane. Okay, this is the conjugate part. If this is x plus jy, above, below is x minus jy. And then remain to be in the complex plane until they meet at the break-in point. Once they meet at the break-in point, okay, then they are back to the real axis. Okay, when the roots are complex conjugate, then only the system is underdamped. Okay, so when is the system underdamped? From the breakaway to the break-in. From the breakaway to the break-in, and breakaway is 0.17 and break-in is minus 3.4. 0.17 say 5.83. The value of K actually. The value of K, and that is what I have written in this answer. Okay, 0.17 to 5.83. Is that clear to everyone now? Is that clear to everyone now? Okay. No, first was underdamped only, Zion. Yes. Now everyone back on the screen. GSHS given to you was KS plus 2 divided by SS plus 1. KS plus 2 divided by SS plus 1. Okay, now if you look into this, okay, what is the quick, suppose if it's a MCQ question, what is the quick sketching? Okay, for the MCQ question, because MCQ matlab only options you have to identify, right? Only options. So this is very important to be learned, very important to be learned, quick sketching. So for the quick sketching, what will I do? Listen everyone, just important, listen everyone. For the quick sketching, first of all, do what? Sketch first of all the poles and zeros quickly. Pole is at 0, minus 1, and the 0 is at minus 2. Okay. Just sketch the pole and 0. Okay. Listen, everyone. No need to take much calculations here. Now, the branches will start from the open loop poles. The branches, basic points of mind may fix. And what I am telling, calculations can be skipped, but concept has to be fixed in mind. Without concept, you can't proceed. So what is the concept? That the branches starts from open loop poles. So I will start one of the branch from this pole. Okay, from this pole. Another branch from minus 1. Okay, another branch from origin, sorry. Okay, where will the branch from minus 1 start? Obviously towards right, because quickly you can see, if I take the branch here, so here the even number property will come. I don't want even number. What I want the odd number. Okay, total number of poles and zeros towards the right is an odd number, and this odd number property is observation. This is not a calculation. So I'm telling something on observation but not on the calculation. So a branch will start from minus 1 to the right. A branch will start from the origin to the left. Okay, no need to calculate exact breakaway point. I am not interested in the exact calculation. But I am telling the quick way. Exact we have done. Exact abhi hum log karke aaye hain. We have done the exact calculation. But picture kya bana? Two branches traveling towards each other. So they must meet because they are traveling towards each other. So they meet where? They meet at the breakaway point. And after meeting at the breakaway point, they move in the complex plane. Complex plane mein where? Left or right? Where, sir? Where? Left or right? Matlab, where you will make them go? Towards the conclusion. And conclusion is towards the open loop zero or asymptote. Okay. So that is why I'll make them go towards left. Okay. And because complex branches are symmetric, I've told you root locus is symmetric. Keep all the points that I've told in your mind fixed. Root locus is always symmetric. Root locus is always symmetric with respect to the real axis, just by the symmetry. And because there is symmetry, once they have gone into the complex plane, so they will once again come back. That is fixed. If they have gone into the complex plane and if they have to come to the zero beta, zero is located where? Zero is located on the real axis. Now, so ultimately you have to come back to the zero, and to come back to the zero, you will obviously come to the real axis. You will come to the real axis. To come to the real axis, and when you come back to the real axis, this becomes the break-in point. Mark your arrows. Okay. This becomes your break-in point. This becomes your break-in point. Okay. And after break-in point, take them towards the conclusion. One of the branch will go towards the open loop zero. Another one will go towards infinity. That is how the quick sketch come up. Okay. Even if you do this much, your options will match. So maybe, okay, if you do little practice, this is just the beginning, but if you do little practice, I'll tell you, such questions in MCQ may be solved within 30 to 40 seconds. That's it. Maybe 30 to 40 seconds is sufficient. Okay. Maybe the 30 to 40 seconds is sufficient. Right. So if you solve it in this domain, if you solve it in this way, MCQ questions, maybe to 30 to 40 seconds is just sufficient, right? Got this one? Just roughly, I have not even calculated breakaway point, no Rao-Hurwitz required, nothing. Okay. Just GSHS given, directly taken the poles and zeros, and by the basic properties, basic observation of the root locus, the plot is there, your options will match. Your options will match. Agreed or not? How many understood this? Quickly comment. This is important for MCQ, and because I've told I'm going to take a class dedicated on MCQ, the such quick approaches must be known. Must be known. Everyone just waiting for your replies. Is that clear or not? Yes. Yes, Venkatadri, there's not only one, there are multiple benefits of frequency domain, so that we'll study once we go to the frequency domain. Yes, actually Zion, not always. not always, okay, but mostly such plots form the circle. Form the circle. If you want, you have the techniques to prove it as circle. Take the center and radius, or maybe if you want it exactly, it is a circle or not. So you can take any point lying on the root locus will satisfy. Angle GSHS equal to plus minus 180 degree. So take the angle GSHS equate to 180 degree. You are going to get a circle. You are going to get the equation of circle, right? Yes. So options will be very easily satisfied. So with respect to MCQ, that is why starting with the, you know, regular conventional problems, obviously Manish, breakaway and break in obviously will lie on the root locus. It represents the intersection of root locus branches. Kiski branches? Root locus branches. So they always lie on the root locus. It is impossible to find the breakaway or break in point that is not on the root locus. That is a point of the root locus only. Fine. Yes. Yes, fine. So that's it for the today's class. Only thing is, you should understand. Okay, you should be benefited. Otherwise, you see this 1 hour session, I'm extending to nearly to 1 hour 45 minutes, more than 1 hour 45 minutes. But if you are benefited, that's more than enough for me. And I'll tell you, and I've told you, I've obviously told you before also, tomorrow we are going to take the cases of very important angle of departure and angle of arrival. Angle of departure and angle of arrival. Okay, that's going to come tomorrow at 8 p.m. Tomorrow at 8 p.m. And others who are following the ESE mains classes, tomorrow in the ESE mains classes at 9 a.m. on the GradeUp app. Okay, I'm continuing with the conventional questions of Nyquist and Bode. Okay, Nyquist and Bode. Right. Okay, so this is, you know, if you want more dedicated study with proper derivations and with proper theory definitions to be covered, everything that will be found in the proper batches, because you have a dedicated team of faculties, making you prepare, and you have 500 hours plus hours of live classes with a dedicated study plan, 5000 plus practice questions, study notes, full length mock test, daily and subject test. And one important thing, if you are really enjoying control systems and want to learn in detail, the total detail A to Z, when I take anything in the batch, I take two things, A to Z of the theory, so that you don't have to refer any book in the world, and I take 0 to 100 of numerical, matlab 0 level to 100 level. That is what my approach is. And just, you know, very luckily and coincidentally, I can say that this Sunday, okay, I am in the target batch. I'm going to start with the subject of the control systems only. Okay, control systems in full detail. Okay. So obviously, maybe after this week, at least in the YouTube, maybe my classes of control system may be at halt. Because I'm going into the batch right now. I don't know when it will resume, but definitely if it resumes, I'll come up with more topics. But right now, this week, two more classes are there. Root locus tomorrow, angle of departure and angle of arrival, very important. And then day after tomorrow, maine bola Saturday, only all variety of MCQ and NET questions will be covered. Okay, so stay tuned into your favorite GradeUpGate YouTube channel. And if you're interested, come watch me live on the target batch. Enroll for the target batch. If you're interested, drop a comment. The team will coordinate with you regarding all the things. So if anyone's interested, if you don't know much clarity about the batch, and if you're interested, yes, maybe I can go for the batch. Just put a comment here. Okay, if you want to learn the complete control systems, and not only by me, other faculties, again, in the very interesting way, they will be teaching other subjects also. So if you are interested, okay. Maybe I'm not sure about joining or not, but if you're interested, yes, what happens in the batch, please comment here. The team itself is going to coordinate with you, right? Chaliye. So with that, I will sign off. Okay. To know any information about the batch, okay, just contact the GradeUp team. Okay. Maybe if you hesitate to comment here, okay. Yes, Ramu, sure. Okay. Yes, Ishumoni, even for EDC, MN Ramesh sir is very highly experienced, as I've shown you now, the faculty team. MN Ramesh sir is actually one of the most experienced faculty, has more than 17 plus years of experience. Okay, so if you are interested, you can contact the contact number, email ID given here. ठीक है, ईमेल आईडी गिवन हियर एंड नेक्स्ट क्लास टुमारो रूट लोकस 2 at 8 PM एंगल ऑफ अराइवल एंड एंगल ऑफ डिपार्चर. ओके, सो विद दैट आई विल साइन ऑफ. See you tomorrow. And in the engineering services mains class, those who are following, Nyquist and Bode coming up. Bye-bye. Take care. Sleep well and enjoy your studies. Take care. Prep smart, score better and go grade up. Right. Yes, issue timings and all. It can be found on the app. Can be found on the app.